Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to download and install the current MySQL version. We will install MySQL Server, Shell, as well as Workbench. Let's start. After installing, you can also refer our free 3 hours MySQL tutorial. The link is in the description of this video. Let's start. Go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any web browser. On Google, type MySQL and press enter. Open the official website mysql.com. Here it is. Click downloads. Go below and click here, MySQL community downloads. Now go to MySQL installer for Windows. The following is the current version. Okay, 8.0.37 and for Windows. Two versions are visible. It's written 32-bit but works for both 32-bit as well as 64-bit Windows 11 operating system. I'll go for the second one. Okay. Click the download button. Now here click no thanks, just start my download. Download started. Here it is. Let's wait 296 MB. The download is successful. Right click and click open. Minimize. Now the installation will start. Now let us choose a setup type. The installation started. I'll go for custom. Click next. Now under select products, click on MySQL servers, click it again and reach here. Click the arrow to drag. Now go to applications, MySQL workbench and do the same. Drag and do the same for shell. Drag it. Click next. Okay, it will also check the requirements and it will install the following as well. You may or may not get this requirement. If you are already having this redistributable package, it won't get installed. Click execute. We were not having it, so it is installing. Click I agree. Install. Successful. Click close. We have installed it. Click next. Now it will install MySQL. Click execute. One by one it will install. We have installed it. Click next. Click next again. Type in networking. The port number is 3306. Click next. Authentication method, keep it a default, that means strong, and it is recommended. Click next. Now you need to set the password. Root means the admin. You are the admin of the MySQL on this system, on your system, so add a password. Some people got stuck here and were unable to set a strong password. So you can use my password. This is only on the local system, not on the server. So we can use any password. Click next. You can also use your password. As I told before, click next. Windows service, click next. File permissions, yes, keep it as it is, the default. Click next. The last step, apply configuration. Click execute. The configuration is successful and the installation also. Click finish. Next, it will also open MySQL Workbench. When I'll click finish, No problem. Okay, it is opening. Here it is, Workbench. Let us set the path. It was in C drive, program files, MySQL, server, bin, and that's it. This is the complete path. Copy, minimize, go to start, type environment and click here. That is edit the system environment variables. Click open. Under system properties, advanced, click environment variables. Under system variables, go to path, double click, click new and right click, paste the same MySQL bin path. Okay, click OK, OK and the last OK. Now go to start, type cmd, open it. Now let us verify the installation. We have completed the installation. MySQL space hyphen hyphen version. And we successfully installed 8.0.37. Now let us begin the server. Type the command MySQL space hyphen u. U means user. So our user was root. And hyphen p. P means password. When I'll press enter, it will ask the same password. So I'll mention the same password. Here it is, successful. Now let us type some quick commands. Show databases, semicolon. These are the default databases. Let us quickly create a new database. Create databases, database name. Let's say my database name is AmitDB. You can add any name. Press enter and we created it because it's written query OK. Now type the same command, show databases. And you can see AmitDB database is visible. That means we successfully created it. Let us know the path of this database. It will be under C drive, program data. If you're not getting this because it would be hidden on Windows 11, go to view, show and click on this option, hidden items. I'll uncheck and it will vanish. You can see. I'll just click hidden items and it's visible here. Go inside, go to MySQL, server, and here is your data folder. Click continue. Here is your AmitDB. Same AmitDB database. You can always take a backup from here. So you should know this path. Okay guys, so we have created a database. Okay, now we can open Workbench also. Click here. Enter the same password. Select save password and click OK. We are inside MySQL Workbench. Workbench is like a UI for MySQL. If you don't want to type these commands, you can directly go here. You can also type commands here. If you want a free MySQL tutorial as well as MySQL Workbench tutorial, refer the link in the description of this video. Thank you for watching the video.